It was exactly high noon when I approached the Luxembourg. I found only one of my adversaries waiting, the first musketeer I'd happened to bump into in my haste to follow the man with a scar. good day, monsieur. I trust I've not kept you waiting.
For 10 seconds, and for each of them, I shall put 10 stabs in your gullet. Ha! On guard!
Apple!
Wait! Someone approaches. Well, Porthos, what brings you here?
I have an appointment to meet. Mon Dieu, here he is.
What?
En garde!
Athos! Athos! Hello!
Oh, it is Aramis.
What brings you here, friend Aramis?
A matter of honor. I was standing outside the... There he is. En garde.
Wait a minute, Aramis.
Look here. No, let me have him.
Gentlemen, one moment. Obviously, I cannot discharge my obligation to all three of you. Now, let's see. I bumped into this gentleman first. Therefore, he has the first right to kill me.
What matters which of us has the satisfaction? Are we not Athos?
Porthos.
Aramis, one for all.
And all for one.
Perhaps I can offer a solution. As long as you gentlemen consider yourselves one, I will be most happy to engage all three of you at once. I can only be killed a single time on guard.
Wait! Look, you!
Richelieu's guards!
5 of them!
Country boy, you'll have to wait until we've disposed of these intruders.
This is bad, Athos. We are 3 against 5, and you are already wounded.
Not so, gentlemen, not so. I fight with you against Richelieu. We are 4 against 5.
You?
Yes.
What think you? Shall we accept his sword with ours?
How can we refuse in the face of these bloodthirsty villains? 4 for all and all for 4. On guard!
Next moment, we were comrades instead of adversaries. We dispensed with the Richelieu swordsman in short order, wounding 4 of them and chasing the 5th down the street. Then we proceeded to a tavern, where the 3 musketeers drank my health and welcomed me as one of them. But as we sat in the tavern laughing and joking, we had no knowledge of what was taking place in Richelieu's chambers at that very moment. Otherwise, we mightn't have been so happy.
Come in, Rochefort.
Your Eminence, I have great news. The Duke of Buckingham has been recalled to England.
Then our plan is working. This should convince the king that we have no other choice except to declare war on England.
Only one person stands in our way, Your Eminence.
I know. The Queen. She will try to prevent His Majesty from engaging in a war. We must find a way to discredit her in the king's eyes.
Be of good cheer. The Queen herself has played right into our hands.
How so? Speak quickly.
Before leaving France, the Duke of Buckingham paid a visit to the Queen. Naturally, he requested her to intercede with the King and avert a war. She promised that she would exert her influence, and to prove her friendship, she gave the Duke her diamond necklace.
The one presented to her by the King when they were married?
The same.
How very indiscreet of her. I will go to the King and tell him that his own wife conspires with England against him. If he does not believe me, I will suggest that he ask the Queen what she has done with her betrothal necklace. If she tells him the truth, he will suspect intrigue on her part. If she does not tell him the truth... Let us see if the Queen can manage to save her reputation this time.
The following morning, I received a summons to report to the office of Monsieur de Treville. I was delighted, for I thought I was going to be accepted as a musketeer then and there. But when I arrived, I found Athos, Porthos, and Aramis waiting in the outer chamber. They, too, had been summoned. It was all very mysterious. We waited anxiously until de Treville called us into his office.
Come in, gentlemen. I have a mission for you, the most dangerous mission you have ever undertaken. D'Artagnan, if you succeed in this and demonstrate your courage and bravery, I will formally proclaim you to be a musketeer together with these 3 whose friendship you have made.
Thank you, monsieur. I'll succeed, or die in the attempt.
Now listen closely, all of you. Richelieu is engaged in a new plot to discredit the Queen and embroil France in a war with England. The Queen has given her diamond necklace to the Duke of Buckingham. It was an innocent gesture of her friendship, but Richelieu has twisted it in the King's mind until he believes that the Queen has betrayed him to England.
This will surely mean war.
And if France engages in war, Richelieu, as Prime Minister, will have control of the country and all its resources.
Which is, of course, exactly what he desires.
How can we prevent it, sir?
By going to England and obtaining the Queen's necklace. The King has already questioned her regarding its whereabouts. He has also announced a grand ball and has commanded the Queen to wear the necklace on that occasion.
Hmm. Did the queen admit she'd given the necklace to the duke?
She did not dare tell the king for fear that he would not believe the gift was an innocent one of friendship.
Then what did she tell him?
That she would wear the necklace at the grand ball, of course. She pretended that it was still in her possession.
Say no further. The necklace must be obtained and returned in time for the grand ball. When do we leave for England?
Tomorrow morning at the stroke of one. I have arranged for your transportation and protection as well as I can. But Richelieu's guards have orders to kill you on sight. They will stop at nothing to prevent your departure and return. You four will go together. If three fail, perhaps the fourth will succeed. Here are your instructions. Godspeed, and may success crown your efforts.
Our orders were to proceed to a tavern in Chantilly, where we were to meet a man who would supply us with a boat for crossing the channel. We had no idea who the man was. We could only recognize him by a secret password.
Hold! This is the tavern. Dismount!
Thank heaven for some shelter at last.
Well, we entered the tavern and seated ourselves at a table. Presently, a man approached from the other side of the room. Was this our friend?
Good evening, gentlemen.
Good evening, sir.
You have come a long way, I observe.
From Paris. And you, monsieur?
I come from Paris also.
Ah, fellow traveler. Sit down, my friend, and join us in a hot drink.
You don't have the appearance of a sailor, monsieur.
Really? And were you expecting a sailor?
We were expecting a friend.
Drink up, gentlemen. It's needed to warm the chill. To the king!
To the king!
Wait. I believe I can propose a better toast. To Richelieu.
To Richelieu!
Hunter! The whole tavern was filled with Richelieu's guards. We fought bitterly, side by side, and were almost at the door when the villains, seeing we were about to escape, dropped their swords and resorted to gunpowder. Their aim was better with firearms, and the shots found their marks. Athos and Porthos were hit. I started back to save them, but Aramis stopped me.
No, D'Artagnan. One of us must succeed. Hurry! Go!
Another shot rang out. Aramis fell to the floor. My comrades were done for. I was the only one left. I slashed my way out to the door, jumped on my horse, and galloped off. I was urging my horse with all speed. Then suddenly, looking back, I saw I was being followed. Turned off into the foliage at the side of the road and waited. Then I saw him, the other rider. It was the man who'd accosted us at our table. Richelieu's spy, come to prevent my escape. I waited until he rode near me. Then I jumped from my horse to his and pulled him to the ground. We fought for a moment. Then he eluded my grasp, rolled away, and came up with his sword drawn. I whipped my blade from its sheath. On guard!
On guard!
He was a poor swordsman, lunging about wildly to no effect. Suddenly, I parried a thrust, then countered, and whipped his blade from his hand.
No.
I backed him up against a tree and pinned him there. My own sword pointed at his throat.
No. No, do not run me through.
Ah, the brave one turns coward quickly, huh? Give me your papers.
Yes, only do not hurt me. Here are the papers.
Count Luzon, one of Richelieu's guards. And what's this? Come speak up, man, or...
My pass to leave the country. I was to follow you by boat if you escaped us at the tavern.
What boat?
One engaged by Richelieu. It waits at the landing at the end of this road.
Good. I failed to make contact with my own boat. I'll use yours.
You won't get far, monsieur. The captain of that boat has orders to shoot you on sight.
Has he? Then perhaps I should take you along to vouch for me.
Oh, that will do no good. He doesn't know me. He would only believe my papers.
Would he? Thank you for the information, monsieur. Now, lie down.
You're not going to hurt me.
I'm going to bind and gag you. Lie down.
No.
Calm yourself, monsieur. I don't kill dumb animals.